Hi, it's Randy from Reefs.com on the showroom floor of Reefapalooza, New York. I'm here with George Kotland, all the way from Germany.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. George represents Easy Reefs, which is a new food product. Many of you have probably seen videos of people using it online and whatnot. I actually have some myself. It's a fantastic product, and George is going to tell us what goes into it.
Yeah, absolutely. So yeah, so what we are most known for currently is of course the mastic. Yeah, so this is our food paste. You see, it comes as a powder and then becomes activated with water. Yeah,
yep.
So then you have this sort of paste which you can stick on almost any surface in the aquarium. So the fishes can go there and just according to their natural feeding behavior, like grazers or something,
right, so it's fantastic.
They just
grazing
pass
fish.
By, yeah. Mm-hmm. Pass by, picking and go away.
Right.
So that's pretty much the opposite of what we used to do in our aquariums when we feed pallets of frozen food.
Right.
It takes maybe just 2 minutes and everything is gone. Yeah.
That's right.
So this is what we are basically doing with our product. So what we are doing is we are harvesting the shrimp in our own natural reserve. Yeah, this belongs to us. And
Germany?
No, this is at the Atlantic coast in Spain.
Okay.
So close to the city of Cadiz. And then this shrimp, which is harvested, goes straight into our facility for freeze drying.
Mm.
When the shrimp arrive, it's almost alive. That means all the nutrition is still there.
Sure.
Yeah, because from the moment an animal is dying, also the nutrition value drops down significantly.
Yeah, so quickly. I think people are surprised at how.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
you know, yeah. that we are talking about 30 minutes or something like that, which have already a big impact. Yeah, so it's really important to really work with fresh food.
Sure.
Yeah. So, and this shrimp is more or less the main ingredients of our product.
Okay.
We are then adding our own phytoplankton species, which we are producing by ourselves, and one macroalgae. That's it.
Okay.
Yeah. So we are not adding. Many people ask us sometimes, you know, what are you putting inside the food?
What's the secret? Right?
I think the secret is really the freshness.
Sure.
Yeah. It's not about a certain ingredients or something. Yeah. It's really the freshness that makes the difference.
Because I think what Easy Reefs is known, at least here for most, is getting very finicky, difficult to feed fish, feeding rather easily.
Yeah.
Which is really pretty incredible.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. We are doing some research on what can be the trigger. You know, to motivate these fishes.
Yeah.
We are working in certain directions, and I think we will come out with something soon,
right,
because we understand now much better how the process is, how fishes decide if this is a food or not.
What to hit, what not, right.
Exactly,
yeah,
exactly.
Yeah.
But it's not, it has not to do with the ingredients.
Mm.
It's really the freshness that makes the difference.
Interesting.
Yeah, in that case.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
And
yeah,
to improve, because we know that introducing mastic into your aquarium is sometimes, it's a bit inconvenient compared to
just
giving pallets or frozen food or something.
Yeah.
And we are aware of this. And we are trying to optimize this in the future. And I can show you something that I'm working on is this plug here, for example.
Yeah.
This is like the low-end version. So we have a simple suction cap and we have these plugs here. And you see there are those pins.
Yeah.
So we have a wide area here in the center, and then between the pins there are small areas. So what happens is when you introduce the mastic, you put it on the pin, on this plug, and then you put it in the tank, and the big fishes, they will start grazing first, you know? And they will graze here the center parts. Yeah, but then after some time they are losing the interest,
yeah,
and then the smaller species have plenty of time to pick in between those pins.
Right.
Yeah. So this is also part of our philosophy.
Yeah.
You know, we want to offer products which really meet the needs of the aquarium, because we have so many different species in our aquariums.
Right, right.
Yeah. We don't have just one type of fish in there.
Right.
It's more like a zoo. Yeah, and
right,
so we want to take care of these things so that the fishes really get everything is covered.
Yeah, that's
there.
A really, really good
yeah?
point.
So this is a prototype.
Because when you just stick it to the glass, the tangs, the rabbit fish,
yeah,
whatever, they come by, they can take it all.
Absolutely.
So fast,
and to make it more convenient, the further idea is These plugs are going to be really cheap, so the people can buy them in bigger quantities. Yeah, and then you can prepare the mastic. You can load all the plugs, and we also supply a crate, so they can put it in a crate and in the freezer. So whenever they need it, they just pull out the crate, pull out the plug, and just plug it in.
How long would it last in a freezer situation?
It's like about 5 weeks.
Oh, that's perfect. Yeah.
So they can prepare a crate maybe with 14 plugs.
Yeah.
So that's maybe about 10 days, 2 weeks or something like that.
And it does become easy reef.
Exactly.
Right.
And this is where we want to go, you know, because we understand that it is inconvenient, but it's worth doing it. Yeah. So this is like the low-end version I mentioned to you.
Sure.
We are also planning to come up with a more advanced version, which is this this holder here. And
multiple plugs.
Yes, you can add multiple plugs. You see there's a sort of locking system here.
Yeah.
So you can put it here and then it drops down so the fishes cannot pull it out. Only you can remove it by lifting it and removing it. So this is one of the ideas.
So if you have a larger aquarium, larger population of fish,
you can feed them.
Yeah.
So this is one part of the idea. The other part is this is supposed to become a multiple holder. So we will also we are also looking into coming up with a feeding cylinder, for example. So the people, this is why these hangers are here.
Yeah.
So you can add a feeding cylinder here, and then you can move over the plugs to the other side. So you can make both things at the same time, because there are grazers in the tank, but there are also fishes in the tank who prefer the frozen food.
Sure.
You know, like Antias, for example.
That's right.
They
also go
on mastic, but they prefer to feed on open water.
Right.
Yeah. So, and to really, as I said, you know, we want to make it possible for the people to really meet all the specifications in their aquariums.
Sure.
You know?
Yeah,
this
it's really, it's a really terrific idea.
Products.
I love that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have exactly that kind of mix of fish in my own tanks, and it would be terrific to be able to address them all easily.
Absolutely.
And
this is the standard. I mean, there are really not a lot of people who treat really only one species. It's really the mix. But we need to make sure that we act according to what is in the aquarium.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this is what I wanted to tell you about the mastic. There's also news coming for the Easy Booster. You know, the Easy Booster is our phytoplankton gel.
Okay.
The benefit of using a gel is you don't have the problem, like when you have phytoplankton in these bottles, for example, the problem there is you are exposing it to light. First problem, because this is reducing the nutrition. Yeah, simply because of the UV rays. The next problem is oxygen. Yeah, so you're exposing it to oxygen, which will minimize the vitamin C content in it, because vitamin C is very sensible to any type of oxygen.
Right.
Next problem is you need to shake it before dosing. So even
if it all settles. Right.
Exactly. Yeah. So even if you have a connection here, you cannot attach it to a dosing system.
Right.
Yeah. And this is where we come. We have the Easy Booster. The Easy Booster is a gel. Yeah, it has a very high viscosity. So that means no matter how you turn it, the density of the phytoplankton cells inside is always the same.
It's not
settling down anywhere. So we had always from the beginning this hanger here because we wanted the people to encourage to put it on the dosing device. But wait a second, we didn't have a connector. We had a sort of DIY solution where we said drill a hole inside the cap and things like that.
Right.
So right now, what you see here, this is really one of the new products which we will release soon.
Right.
It's a simple connector, which you can
just plug it in.
You just plug it in. Yeah, you have a valve here. You can connect it to your dosing system. And I think this is going to make a really difference, because that means for your system, you have a constant dosing of phytoplankton, which is really important, you know?
Right.
It's not a day-by-day choose or something, you know? You really can do, you can set your dosing system according to what the needs of your tank.
Yeah.
And this will make a huge difference, because
make it a lot easier to keep a lot of animals that we have trouble with.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Because what you need, what you do with the phytoplankton feed is you are feeding the zooplankton in your aquarium. This is the main target we are focused on. Yeah. And they need constant feeding. Yeah. You cannot do it day by day, or maybe you then you skip a day or a week or something, because that means your zooplankton population will drop down again. And so, and this is why I think this is really going to be a game changer for all those people who are looking for a more professional solution of the dose phytoplankton in their systems.
It's fascinating. So it's so simple that
But it's often, you know, think of the floating magnet.
Right.
I mean, what was the invention, you know, just make it flow.
Sometimes but it was a simple solution is the best solution.
Absolutely.
Right? Absolutely.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you very much, George.
No problem.
Really,
it was a
pleasure meeting you. Pleasure talking with
you.
Really interesting products, and I'm already a fan of the Mastic, so I look forward to seeing the rest of the stuff.
Okay, cool.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye, guys. Okay.